et que cela l'affectait beaucoup et qu'il ressentait des sentiments pour les personnes de même sexe. En venant à la synagogue église de toutes les nations, Dieu a utilisé le prophète Tibi Joshua et a prophétisé dans sa vie et il a reçu sa délivrance de cet esprit qui le tourmentait. Aujourd'hui, il dit qu'il est libre et que cette envie de rencontrer d'autres hommes a complètement disparu. Il rend grâce à Dieu et le bénit pour sa délivrance dans sa vie.
How are you? Where's your husband?
He's in Ghana.
Your husband is in Ghana?
Yes, man of God.
You people married when?
2011.
What has happened now?
Man of God.
Do you know the reason why I'm saying this? I'm saying broken home.
It's true, man of God.
Hmm?
Yes.
I have to, your husband is where? Ghana. Your husband is where? Ghana. Which husband is that? Okay. Is that true to deceive ourselves?
No, man of God.
Can you see?
Yes,
if I'm not patient, I will leave you just like that.
Yes.
But I'm patient enough to drive you to know that you are deceiving yourself. This is the problem of your family, that is divorce.
Yes, man of God.
Come on, come here. So, come on. God loves you. Come on.
L'homme de Dieu lui a demandé où est-ce.
Emmanuel, my name is Mrs. Gloria Abiwu, and I'm from Ghana. Last Sunday, a man of God prophesied to me, as you've seen, where is my husband and what is happening, when did we get married, that this is, you can see separation and is a problem in the family. I confirm the prophecy to be 100% true. After I got married to my husband in 2011, barely a year, my husband told me that even if I strike myself naked, it doesn't trigger any feeling in him. He doesn't feel anything for me. And he won't talk to me. If I talk to him, he'll frown his face back to me. And he has so much deteriorated that he will not hug me, he will not kiss me. From 2013 to today, there is nothing like relationship, no sex, nothing. And he has even given me back his ring. And when I look at his phone, it's not that there are so many women that I see.
Don't judge your husband. Let your husband explain himself.
Man of God told me that he's going to call my husband, and I believe he's here.
Let him come out. They are young people, you know. You know, we young people, we lack of patience and all of that. Let's hear from them.
My name is Dr. Hilarious Abiwu. I'm the medical superintendent in charge of Karachi West District Hospital in Ghana. I also act as the district director of health services for Karachi West District. And from 2009 to middle of last year, I've been the only resident medical officer in this hospital that serves a population of about 60,000, in addition to 5 other districts that do not have a hospital. Now, last Monday, I received a call, and the caller indicated that the man of God wanted to see me about a prophecy that was apparently given to my wife in synagogue. I think the prophecy was last Sunday, and that's how I ended up coming here. Now, to start with, I think that the prophecy.
I want to thank you for honoring prophet. And the Bible says, he who honor a prophet because he's a prophet will receive prophetic reward. Thank you.
Yeah, first of all, I think I need to confirm that everything the man of God is true. True beyond what anybody else would think. Indeed, the word the man of God spoke actually reflects my thoughts, my intentions, and my declarations in my heart, which I haven't even opened to anyone else. And that's how true and how deep the prophecy is. Now, to start with, what we call marriage started on a very wrong footing. I met my wife for the first time in 2011. That's the very first time I've ever seen her. And we had some chats and discussions, and along the line, we realized that perhaps we share values that perhaps we could go ahead and maybe consider marriage. Within 2 weeks, the only thing I keep on hearing is marriage. 2 weeks of ever seeing her. And the next I knew, the mother had also gotten information, apparently, that I had proposed I was going to get married to her. And then how I was going to do that, when, and all of that. And now once the issue had gone out of between the two of us alone to the family, the pressure was now imminent. Now, before we knew it, well, counseling had started. To the point where we got to the counseling ground, finally, and I indicated to them that, look, there is a certain burden on me. I am not happy. And to the extent that I'm not happy, I don't know what the problem is, but there seems to be no connection, no link between the two of us. And so I'll prefer that we defer this marriage and resolve the issues before the marriage takes off. She wasn't willing to listen to anything. Indeed, she won't listen because anybody who tries to prolong their marriage is an agent of the enemy trying to snatch, you know, the good thing that has come into her hand. Indeed, even the counselor told me that even if I had to pretend for the marriage to go on, I should do that. And then I said that, well, let me tell them, I know myself too well, and that I foresee the problem we are here today trying to solve happening because I know myself too well and I don't get easily moved. And it can only take a miracle of God for me to change under those circumstances. The marriage happened. And for 2 years, my wife remained with the mother. And I have to leave my patients and come and be attending to her needs under her mother's roof. For 2 years. That's not even enough. There was now pressure and emotional blackmail. Why I wasn't doing that as frequently as they expect me to. Maybe every other weekend. And this is about 6 hours drive from where she lives. I have to cross rivers in order to be able to get to that destination. She takes care of bottles. I take care of human lives. And yet I'm the one who has to leave everything to come and now attend to her needs under her mother's roof. Even after sacrificing my education and everything just to make sure that the marriage she wanted within a certificate of agency was granted. I was still living like a single man. Well, before the marriage, we had agreed, and I told her specifically that there are a number of things as we go into this marriage. One, I don't want to have anything to do with babies within 2 years of that marriage. It wasn't even 6 months. The mother was sponsoring her left, right, center, goes to see this doctor, go and see this gynecologist, all in an attempt to go and get pregnant. I was stationary watching what? All the drama. The baby was not coming. The mother invited me and told me that, look, he saw my boss finally, my medical director in the regional hospital, and he told her that my wife doesn't have any problem. The only problem she has is to go and stay with her husband and she'll get pregnant. So she's releasing her to me. And I thought that was the end of the first chapter. We can now begin to start afresh.
I think I need to see your mom. So because of that, I will not allow you to leave. Because this marriage is of God. I need to see your mom so that your mommy will understand our level in this issue. I think interfering of the mama is is becoming too much. This marriage is at a brink of divorce. Thank you. So please, my daughter, please, you have to wait for me. Let's suspend everything until I see Mama. Okay.
The following week, the lady's mother honored the invitation of the man of God and came to the synagogue Church of All Nations to listen to the voice of God concerning the marriage. Watch as Prophet TB Joshua is guided by the wisdom of Solomon and the right knowledge of God which settles peace.
Hearing the voice of God, that will solve the problem. And I know immediately she heard. She said, this is the mother, this is the daughter, and this is our brother. I was saying this marriage is of God. Sometimes we feel we love our daughter so much. Maybe our daughter is our pet. So we have so much love. That kind of love sometimes spoils the whole thing. When the marriage is established, they don't want to intrude again. There's little we can do or say or trying to influence. So because they want to establish a home. Our advice is good sometimes, but not all the time. So this is exactly what happened. So I think we have done so much in interfering into the relationship of this marriage, and it has affected the marriage greatly. This is why I invite you, and I'm happy. My brother, I know for quite a long time, when this marriage has been going on, there is so much pain, and I think something must have gone wrong. Yes, we expected that. But hearing this is God's relationship, settle the matter. Whatever might have gone wrong, which I know, on your side, your own side, relationship with others and promise to settle down with another person, a lot of people want to settle down with you because you believe that this marriage cannot come together again. But here you hear the voice of God. When God say yes, no one can say no. So, and I want you to, what you are going to do for me now, those who are on your neck for relationship, those who are on your neck for marriage, I'm going to meet you, I'm going to invite them, and I'm going to be a pastor, I will pray with them. God will give them a better choice than you. God give us what we don't want sometime. But later we now see is the right thing to protect us, to keep us stronger, and to prepare us for the challenges ahead. Are you with me? Sometimes God gives us a woman we don't want naturally. And we keep saying, this woman is not the woman I would have wanted to marry. But God said, oh, yes, this is the marriage to protect your life. Woman, sometimes God gives us husband. Naturally, we don't like to marry, but we suddenly find ourselves in the house. Bam! After first week, first month, second month, 6 months, sometimes many people a year before they realize that, I would have preferred to marry that man. If you are not married this man, who know what will have happened to you? If you are not married this lady, who know what will have happened to you? Look beyond marriage. Look beyond sleeping on the bed together. There is more to that. And I'm going to talk to Mama. Mama will handsome. And area we want Mama to interfere. The area we want Mama to interfere, we call her to that. Mama have seen and have seen. Mama taught you people cannot live without his counseling. Mama have realized that even his counseling disorganized the whole thing, dislodged the marriage. Some of our mommy, they believe that our daughter, our son will not be able to cope with the marriage without their interfering. But sometimes their interfering causes divorce. If I'm talking to you, whereas sometimes God also allows them to interfere, but in some certain issue. So they say, Mommy, you're a good woman, for have the heart for God. So my brother, I know we need to work on some matter. You listen to what I'm saying? You hurt this man more than the way he hurt you. Two of you share the offense, but you hurt him more than the way he hurt you. You 50%, 15%, 15% hurt, and you 50%. Because I'm not going to talk about my mom, because our mommy tried to help them, but now the help is not working. Mama is ready to help them in prayer, just prayer. I will support you in prayer. If anything you want her to come, you invite her. It's not going to your place without invitation. This is the issue now.
Sur le point de divorcer après la prophétie de Balaam de Dieu avait donné 10 ans qu'il était sur la brèche du divorce. Et nous voyons maintenant la réconciliation et la délivrance
so,
de ce couple.
We need to just talk to our mom and thank her for her support, and also not that we disregard her support, but we just want God to be first, any other advice to be secondary. Okay? Yes. Thank you. Like we have said, we appreciate your support and your love, but we just want God's love first. Any other love should be secondary. So anytime we need you, we need your help, we need your support, we invite you more. You know, Mama, every mama at home, they really want to do, they want to make sure everything is perfect, but sometimes it may not be the will of God for things to run like that. So thank you, Mama. Thank you very much. Thank you, my brother. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Vemos la restauración familiar en esta familia que estaba a punto de divorciarse, pero hace una semana recibieron profecía por parte del hombre de Dios y hoy aquí están siendo restaurados por el amor de Cristo Jesús.
Emmanuel. My name is Dr. Hilarious Abiwu, and on my left hand side is my lovely wife. I am the medical superintendent in charge of the Karachi Wesley Hospital. I also double as the acting district director of health services for the district, and at the national level, I'm the general secretary of all the managers of our hospitals in the country. About a month ago, as was played in the clips previously, my wife was here and received a prophecy concerning a marriage which was heading for the rocks. And on the basis of that prophecy, I was invited by the man of God, and I followed up and responded to that call. And indeed, I need to first of all again, for the second time, confirm that virtually everything the man of God said was true. Indeed, when he mentioned to my wife that which marriage are you talking about, I think what we all need to understand is that at a certain point in that marriage,
I had declared myself, you know, single, and I took my rings off in protest, even though I didn't tell her, I didn't tell anybody. As far as I'm concerned, I was single, even though on paper we were married. So indeed, the man of God was looking beyond what was physical. Now the situation was so bad. We'll be in the house. I mean, if she comes to me, for the period she comes to me, we are like total strangers. I mean, that's how you get any stranger in the house. We hardly talk. I mean, maybe if she asks me anything, I either say yes or no, if I'm in a good mood. Otherwise, I just ignore and walk away. Occasionally, if I think it was okay, I'll send a text message or something if I want to tell her something, you know, that I cannot hold back. Okay, so essentially, this was the kind of situation we're dealing with. She mentioned that we haven't had any sexual encounters. Indeed, that's the case. I mean, nothing intimate, nothing, no sex, nothing, I mean, absolutely nothing for 3 years. And I couldn't be too bothered about that either. Now, so essentially that was it. Comes to food, I mean, I decide what I want to eat. That's if I'm in a good mood, I eat. Otherwise, I have other places I get my food, you know. So, I mean, there was absolutely nothing like marriage, you know, except for what was written on paper, you know, to that there was a marriage. So everything was collapsed. Now, so we came, and then the man of God dealt with the issues, not only from the point of counseling, but also from the spiritual perspective by offering prayer and deliverance and all of that. And we went back. And I can say that the very first thing, the very first evidence of a change that I realized, which was the most important to me, was that the pain, the hurt, and everything which was in my heart was gone. Was gone completely. I mean, it was as though nothing happened. And so then, it offered the opportunity to start afresh. To start with a new beginning. And so the events unfolded. The issues about sexual intimacy now is a thing of the past, but I'll leave that one for her. Maybe she wants to talk about that one. And now, well, she wanted to be engaged. I mean, my activity is not so. So now, well, she drives me to work. Even if it's in the middle of the night, sometimes I get home, usually around 11 p.m. after leaving home around 6. She'll be awake. She'll come to the workplace to come and pick me home. Well, I'm enjoying the chauffeur. She now brings my food to the workplace. I mean, it's just one event after the other. But generally, I think that the fig tree has been cursed from its roots, and we are absolutely sure that it will wither away just as these pieces of evidence are showing. So indeed, it didn't just end there. I think that for that month of February, whilst that prophecy came, even whilst I was away, I didn't even listen to the prophecy, I didn't watch Emmanuel TV that day because I had a meeting on that Sunday. A lot of other things were kicked into action in terms of breakthroughs. Generally, I think that the family has had these problems of stagnation or near success. Everybody tells you in the family that you are doing so well, but when it matters most in terms of recognitions, awards, promotions, it never happens. And I've been at my post for almost 7 years, you know, without any promotion. And yet I get everybody can walk around and says, look, you are doing so well. I mean, how could you have achieved all of this? And yet the promotion simply will not come when it matters most. Within, I can say that within that month of February, two promotions came at the same time. The first promotion had to do with my technical grade as a medical officer to a senior medical officer rank. The second one, which was rejected earlier, about 3 or 4 years back, was my application to the Ghana Health Service Council to be confirmed as a substantive medical superintendent of the hospital I managed. That confirmation also came. So now, from the Ghana Health Service Council, came the appointment as a substantive medical superintendent of the Karachi West District Hospital. I have just received in that month of February the salaries and his arrears for the technical grade, which is the senior medical officer promotion. And in this month, I'm expecting that the managerial appointment also and his salary and arrears will fall in the pot. As if that was not enough, when I came here the first time, the first Sunday, I went back quickly because I asked permission that I needed to go back to work and return the following Sunday. And when I went, I picked up two awards again at the regional level. I was awarded as the overall best health worker for the entire Volta region, 2015, and then also the overall best hospital manager, called the medical superintendent, also for the entire region. Yeah, and two weeks after that, that was after the resolution of the matter, an international NGO located in the US, that is General Electric, and its partners, through their GE Foundation partners, also gave my facility itself, also under my leadership, two new awards. So it's been a month of twos or doubles of everything. Now, so you'll find that on this board are pictures of the plaques I received. The first one here, which is for the best health worker Volta region for 2015, and then the second one, also bearing my name, is best medical superintendent Volta region in 2015. And then on the extreme left, is a citation which was given me by the regional director of health services. I wish I could just give you the last paragraph of this citation just so you appreciate the recognition. Now, it says that in the same year, the regional director of health services also assigned you additional responsibility as the acting district director of health services, in addition to being confirmed a substantive medical superintendent by the Ghana Health Service Council. Indeed, within 6 months of taking up the distressed district health directorate, you and your team ensured that revenues increased by as much as 350% over the previous year and 128% at the end of the year 2015. The DAD and the hospital also received the highest increase in revenue generation in the entire Volta region for 2015 over the previous year's figures. Indeed, of all the facilities in the region, only your hospital is on record to have settled all its indebtedness to the regional medical stores despite non-payment by NHIS. Your proven record of transformational leadership earned you a call up to participate and meet President Obama of the United States of America in 2014 in his flagship leadership program for young African leaders, the Mandela Washington Fellowship. In the selection, over 50,000 applications were received from across the whole of Africa, and only 500 selected, putting you in the top 1% of promising young African leaders. Among this and many other outstanding achievements, the Volta Regional Health Directorate awards you on the 11th day of February 2016 as the best overall regional health worker and the best regional medical superintendent for 2015.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So we can understand from our brother that all of this recognition, promotion, awards actually came within the same period where the word of prophecy was given to his wife and the reconciliation took place, to show you that indeed the Spirit of God is involved. And as he received prayer, not only was the marriage issue settled, but the spirit that was causing backwardness and delay in promotion was also removed, as we can see by the wonderful recognition he's received thereafter. One more time, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ.
Yeah. And again, I think that I indicated that over 3 years I have had to drop my ring in protest. And I think that with the reconciliation, it was proper, even if it's for symbolic reasons, that I go back for what I had dropped 3 years ago. And so now on my finger rests the very same, you know, marriage ring, which was offered in 2011, signifying the dawn of a new day.
Glory be to God. We thank Jesus Christ once again for what he has done in this marriage. And so as you read the citation, you mentioned something briefly concerning an opportunity you had to go to America to meet with President Obama. Can you just briefly explain what happened in that instance?
Yeah, I think that the issues of stagnation and all of that I've mentioned previously. And it was after a period of time when everything appears to come to standstill, no recognition, nothing despite the hard work, I came across, you know, the morning water. I started ministering it, and the significant thing that happened after ministering the morning water, and this was around 2012, what I noticed first of all that happened was that a number of negative dreams which I was having since I was in medical school, in fact, since I was in the university, I mean, I've always dreamt I was wearing primary school uniforms, you know, junior secondary school uniforms. I climb, you know, story buildings, and at a point, I feel I can't go on again, I come down, you know, because I was afraid of the foundations and all of that. Everything changed. I now dream I'm in the university, I've graduated, you know, I'm all over the place, I'm in an MBA class. And so everything changed from the dreams, first of all. And the most significant of them was that I had an encounter in the dream with what I'll call a rebel leader or a spiritual force. It was like my entire community has been in bondage and I couldn't go anywhere. But the numbers were so huge that I decided, well, I can escape. But when I escaped, they were following me. Now, so what I had to do at the time was then I realized that when I fell down and then they were going to capture me, I had the morning water in my pocket. So immediately I brought it out, I sprayed it. The guy came down and I was gone. And that was the beginning of the changes I found. The first thing was that I got admission back to start an executive master's in business administration at GIMPA, Ghana Institute of Management and Public Administration. Whilst there, I studied leadership, and within that same period, I saw this advert by President Obama for some leadership fellowship that was being organized. And there, I put in the application of the very same things that I wrote in the MBA class. And before I knew it, I got, you know, the appointment signed by the ambassador. And before I knew it, I was in the U.S. I mean, what had the recognition that did not come in my home country was not coming from the most powerful person at the time, you know, President Obama. In the university, even at the end of the session, my colleagues gave me the opportunity to be the one who speaks on their behalf, summarizing all. So I was sitting on the high table, you know, representing my colleagues, and met President Obama as well, you know, having some good handshakes. So all of these events started unfolding after the administration of the morning water and keeping faith with the man of God through Emmanuel TV.
Well, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So our brother's explaining that this testimony began even before the prophecy that brought the reconciliation between his wife, how a breakthrough initially started through ministering the morning water. And so we can just see a few items on the board here. Just explain that to us in reference to the testimony you've just shared now.
Okay. Now, at the very bottom, it was a letter that was signed by the ambassador, Ambassador Kress, in 2014, announcing my success through the interviews and selections for the fellowship. This is my ID card I was using in 2013 when I entered GIMPA. I've had to defer the course in order to attend the fellowship and then came back to continue. Now, in the pictures here in Morgan State University, on the stage with all the dignitaries, was myself delivering, you know, the a message on behalf of the fellows to the gathering at the closing ceremony. In my hand also here is a certificate which was awarded to us. In fact, most of our other colleagues in the other universities had either one or two certificates, but in my particular case, we had about six different certificates from the governor of Maryland. We had one also from the council, the mayor, the university, among many others. And then finally, we got the one that was signed by President Obama himself, which is the one here. And in the picture there, you find myself in my typical dress with President Obama in the background. And then this also was the session when the president, before he left the stage, came round to give us, those of us who were positioned very close to him, a handshake, you know, before leaving the podium. And that's President Obama's back there, and that is myself after having a handshake with President Obama.
Glory be to God. We thank Jesus Christ for everything he has done in this family, and especially the wonderful reconciliation that happened after the prophetic word upon all of this breakthrough that initially started. We thank God for crowning it with this wonderful reconciliation. And so we believe you're in a real position to give a word of advice, especially concerning this issue of marriage. Young couples like yourself who may be facing challenges, you're a living example of what Jesus Christ has done, restoring and reconciling your own marriage. What is your advice?
Well, I think that generally for all of us, if we go even on the internet, we find that the divorce rates, you know, are quite high and keep on going high, not only within the world, but even within Christendom as well. I think that, first of all, the devil recognizes that marriages, and for that matter, families, are the foundations of any society. And so if you have to destroy any society, the place to attack is a marriage or family units. And I believe that that is the principal reason that we have a lot of these broken marriages and divorce. Sometimes I hear some people, after 3 months, 1 month of marriage, they are gone. I mean, the divorce, the marriage is gone. Now, for me, I think that, in my view, the fundamental reason this is happening so frequently now is because we have deviated, particularly for those who are Christians, away from the biblical order, the biblical foundation that, you know, the Apostle Paul lays, and where he says specifically, detailing everybody's role. For husband, our responsibility is to love your wife just as Christ loved the church and gave his life for it. For wife, it says it is submission, submission, and submission. And for children, it says respect your parents in the Lord, because it's good for that to happen. And I think that what has happened here with the man of God the very last time we were here was a restoration of that biblical order, which is necessary for the for family units, you know, to stick together. Besides, having put that biblical order and everybody playing his role, as the scripture rightly puts it, it's important for us to learn forgiveness through love. Because it says love is the greatest, and we need to be able to learn to forgive. Because it's only forgiveness that can make us go past all the offenses and still hold on together as family units. But for many who are also going through the same difficulties and problems that we have gone through, I think that we need to take solace and understanding in the man of God's words that anything that is close to God, anything that is of value to God, receives attacks. And so the higher the attack, that is the time to get even more closer to God. And for as long as you believe in God, and for as long as you believe in his prophets as well, the Lord will come through and the pain will become a testimony.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So at this point, we want to hear from your wife as well, her own side of this wonderful reconciliation and testimony. So, madam, you're welcome. Please introduce yourself to us.
Emmanuel. My name is Mrs. Gloria Abiwu, and this is my lovely husband. In fact, I'm the happiest woman ever on this earth today. Last month, on 31st of January, and that's 2 months ago, I came to Synagogue Church of One Nation, and I was privileged to be prophesied to by Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. And in fact, I didn't even know what to say when he approached me, but I thanked him so much that he had the patience to speak to me. And at the end of the prophecy, he told me that he was going to call my husband and reconcile us. And truly, to the glory of God, we are here to testify for the goodness of God. Amen. In fact, after the reconciliation, I never knew that the miracles can be so quick and fast like that. When the very first day we reached Ghana, we met as husband and wife for 3 good years. For 3 good years, I couldn't believe it. It was so amazing. I never knew it to have happened. And that was the beginning of a beautiful marriage. My husband now has his ring on. He doesn't frown at me when I talk to him. He loves me as a husband supposed to love the wife. And I don't even have to go to him to call him for anything. He willingly comes to me. And I'm so happy and overjoyed. And I thank God. And this cannot happen if it's not through God using our Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. It is only through a true man of God like this that this could happen. Because this marriage, in fact, I lost hope. That is why I was here. I never knew it could happen. But God used his man of God, Prophet T.B. Joshua, to restore this marriage to his glory.
A million thanks are not enough for what Jesus Christ has done. So, madam, in the same vein, what is your advice to our viewers all over the world, especially in this area of marriage relationships?
My advice to the viewers all over the world, and especially couples, is that when you have challenges, as the man of God said, don't run away. Dig deep and fight it through. Make sure that you build your relationship with God and let the word of God be the integral part of your being. And trust in God. Have faith in him. And don't forget to watch Emmanuel TV and pray with all the faith tools that man of God has willingly given us, so that one day you also stand here and give your testimony to the glory of God. Amen.
Amen. We thank Jesus Christ once again for this wonderful reconciliation and the breakthroughs that have come. And we pray that God Almighty will continue to give the two of you the grace to make his word the standard for your life. And we know you're coming back with more wonderful testimonies to the glory of God, in Jesus' name.
Nous venons d'entendre le merveilleux témoignage de ce couple. Nous l'avons vu quelques minutes auparavant sur la vidéo. Ils avaient reçu une prophétie. La femme a reçu une prophétie que ce mariage était au point de dépérir, était la verge d'être brisée. Et effectivement, après avoir reçu cette prophétie, son mari a été invité. Ils ont pu confesser tous les deux que vraiment il n'y avait plus d'affection dans le mariage. Le mariage était complètement détruit, que depuis 3 ans ils étaient séparés, ils vivaient sous le même toit, mais sans, comme des étrangers. Et après que l'homme de Dieu leur ait parlé, ils ont reçu leur délivrance. Aujourd'hui, ils reviennent pour donner leur témoignage, disant que vraiment le Seigneur a accompli des miracles. Maintenant, il a maintenant de l'affection pour sa femme, qui maintenant sa femme prend soin de lui, qui vient même la chercher, il vient même le chercher au travail. Il a dit qu'en plus justement de leur délivrance et de fait que l'affection soit revenue, il a aussi été promu dans son travail. Il a reçu 2 promotions, il a reçu encore 2 récompenses et encore deux fois deux récompenses, même venant des États-Unis. Il a plus de 6 récompenses à son actif. Il a maintenant été promu au niveau de son travail. Il est maintenant reconnu de façon internationale car il était le superintendant d'un hôpital au Ghana. Et aujourd'hui, il rend toute la gloire à Dieu comme ça, cela s'est étendu au-delà de son mariage. Il a eu une percée énorme et il rend toute la gloire à Dieu aujourd'hui parce que le Seigneur les a complètement bénis. L'affection est revenue et ils sont comme 2 nouveau-nés.
Hemos escuchado el precioso testimonio de este joven matrimonio procedente de Ghana. La esposa vino a un servicio de domingo aquí en Las Coan, donde recibió una profecía del hombre de Dios preguntándole, ¿dónde está tu esposo? Antes de recibir esta profecía, la esposa estaba a punto de divorciarse y de abandonar al esposo, médico de profesión, y todo en su vida se hallaba estancado. Vivían como dos extraños, sin comunicación ni afecto entre ellos. Tras la profecía del hombre de Dios, el profeta Tebillosua y la consejería, empezó a llegar la paz al hogar, el afecto se restauró y el progreso llegó a sus vidas. Hemos visto en pantalla los certificados de reconocimiento de éxito en su profesión como médico. Hemos visto también los premios al liderazgo, así como el premio Mandela en Washington. También el esposo tuvo la oportunidad de estrechar la mano de Obama en los Estados Unidos, donde recibió un reconocimiento como joven líder. Este matrimonio aconseja a cuidar y a restaurar la relación del matrimonio y la familia, ya que es la base de la sociedad, y que en tiempos difíciles no corras, no huyas de Dios, sino corre hacia Dios. En el nombre de Jesús damos las gracias por este maravilloso testimonio de restauración en el matrimonio. A Dios sea la gloria.
www.goan.org. Go to the Visit Us page. And for those from within Nigeria, you can call the three visit lines that appear on the website. For those from outside Nigeria, there are some frequently asked questions that will assist you in your visit procedure. Remember, it is essential that anyone from outside Nigeria should fill in the questionnaire. Please remember to answer every question that is asked, and after you have filled in the questionnaire, remember to click Send. Please note, you must wait to receive an invitation or confirmation of your visit from us before making any traveling arrangements or flight bookings. All communication with the Synagogue Church of All Nations should be through the following email address, info@goan.org. We look forward to hearing from you. Emmanuel, God with us.
Здравствуйте, меня зовут Рамиль, я из Баку, Азербайджан.
Good morning, my name is Ramil, I am from Azerbaijan.
Я очень рад, что я нахожусь здесь. Здесь я пережил наилучшее, наибольшее присутствие Божие, встречу с Господом Иисусом, с Духом Святым. Я очень рад, что я попал сюда. Благодаря моим братьям во Христе по имени Рамин, с которым я встретился. Но прежде всего я хотел бы отметить то, что до встречи с ним в августе месяце Господь проговорил мне об Африке, но я не понимал этого. Но после моей встречи с Сиби Джорджа, после того, как я увидел его по Ютубу, услышал его голос, я просто влюбился в него и загорелся прийти сюда. И знал, что это мое место.
I'm really happy to be here, and this is very big privilege for me to be here, and very big grace. I heard about Prophet Joshua and I met him on the YouTube, and I was watching, and before that, the Lord spoke to my heart about that you're going to visit Africa, but I'm really thankful for this grace that God gave me to visit this place. I'm very happy, and I met here with Jesus Christ himself. I met here, I was filled here by Holy Spirit when I was on the Sunday services.
Salam, mənim adım Ramildir, mən Azərbaycanlıyam. Emmanuel TV-yə baxın.
Emmanuel, Matthew 1:23. Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call him Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Jesus Christ, to empower his followers to change the world today. Distance is not a barrier to God's move. Emmanuel TV, God with us.
Anywhere you are, distance is not a barrier. Viewers, you are called to battle the spiritual entities which cause crisis in your lives. You and Prophet TV Joshua, together in the name of Jesus, can stop Satan killing, stealing, and destroying your life. Touch the screen right now. Engage with God.
viewers all over the world, wherever you are, I want to start from you. Whatever situation, wherever you are, right now begin to come against every infirmity in your life. Viewers all over the world, begin to come against every infirmity, every spirit that stands against you, every spirit that hinder your way, every spirit that hinder you, every spirit that causes you limitation, every spirit that causes you shortcoming, viewers all over the world, begin to stand against every spirit. In the name of Jesus, stand right now. Right now, order that spirit to go, to go, to go. Begin to order the spirit to go right now. That spirit of killing, stealing, destruction, that spirit that caused you setback, that spirit that caused you shortcoming, begin to order the spirit, order the spirit, order the spirit, order the spirit, order the spirit in the name of Jesus. I order the spirit out of your life, out of your career, out of your business, out of your finances, in the name of Jesus. 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 Viewers all over the world, confess your freedom. Confess your freedom right now. Viewers all over the world, where can you go from His presence? Every hidden sickness in your body, every hidden disease in your body, every hidden affliction in your system, I command them out. 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 In your blood. Out. In your blood. Out. In your kidney. Out. In your liver. Out. 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 Rejoice. Rejoice. Confess your healing.
Confiesa su libertad y su sanidad.
Viewers all over the world, you have been claiming your right. There is nothing wrong. You can claim your right, but don't hold an offense. You can claim your right, but don't hold an offense. Whether you are right or wrong, you have no right to hold an offense. You must be free from offense. Offenses imprison you. Self-imprisonment. When you hold an offense, you are imprisoning yourself. Offense of this, offense of that. You are imprisoning yourself. And the Bible says our spirit must be free to contact the Spirit of God. Viewers, listen. Your spirit must be free. I'm not saying you should not claim your right, but don't hold an offense. Offenses imprison one. Your spirit must be free from all offenses. Wrong accusation? Whatever it is, you are right, you are wrong, your spirit must be free to contact the Spirit of God. I release you in the name of Jesus. I release your spirit from the pain of the past. I release your spirit from past accusation. I release your spirit from pain of the past, past persecution, past pain. Be released! I say to your spirit, be released! Be released! Be released! Be released! In the name of Jesus! I know you are going through major trouble. Hatred, persecution, whatever you are going through. Misjudge or whatever. You have no right to hold an offense. I release you from pain of the past in the name of Jesus. I release you from hurt, I mean deep hurt in the name of Jesus. There is hurt and there is deep hurt. Someone will say, I can never forgive you. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. It's deep hurt. I release you from hurt, deep heart in the name of Jesus. Be released from her. Deep heart. In Jesus' name. Rejoice.
We leave you under the influence of the Holy Spirit and pray to meet you there again. Allow your heart to be deeply engaged with God as you send your testimony. Somebody needs your testimony to strengthen their faith, to get them out of their desperate setback. When you acknowledge God as your healer, as your Redeemer, and as your Savior, He will do it again and again. So what is your testimony? Share it with us. Log on to www.emmanuel.tv, then click on Testimonies. Then type in your name, email address, and other details in the spaces provided. If you wish to upload a picture to attach to your testimony, click on the Browse button, select the picture from where you saved it on your computer, and click Open. Next, type in your glorious testimony in the box below, then click Submit. You can also share your testimony by calling our testimony lines. Each time God leads us through a battle, it is in our own interest to testify to His goodness as a way of thanksgiving for not allowing our adversaries to triumph over us. We look forward to hearing your testimony. The best is yet to come. The Bible, God's special gift to us.
Your Bible is God's gift to you. When the Word becomes an integral part of your being, you begin to see the truth in the Word. There is truth in God's Word. When Jesus was being tempted, He did not cry to Pharisees and Sadducees, "Help me, help me." He answered by quoting the internal Word of God. The book you are carrying is a book in the hands of many, but holy book in the hands of few. When the Bible becomes holy book in your hand, it becomes a tool. The Word of God is the tool in the hands of Holy Ghost. Instrument, weapon. When you are sick, you call the Word, you get healed. When you are poor, you call the Word, you are blessed. When you are being demonized, you call the Word, you are delivered. It becomes a tool, instrument in your hand. Ask God, draw me close to you. Draw me towards you.
The Bible, God's special gift to us.
Joshua and the Emmanuel TV partners provided a washing machine and some essential food supplies for the Mountain of Transformation Rehabilitation Center for recovering drug addicts in Western Ukraine.
Here is the Emmanuel TV team in Ukraine browsing around a superstore to purchase necessary gifts such as washing machines and other essentials that will go a long way to support the work taking place at two rehabilitation centers for men who are recovering from drug and alcohol addictions. Members of the Emmanuel TV team are enthused, as there is more joy in giving than receiving. Their next stop is a food store, where they purchase large bags of quality rice, huge quantities of onions, pasta, potatoes, and eggs, vital ingredients of the Ukrainian diet. Here, the Emmanuel TV team, sent by Prophet TV Joshua and the Emmanuel TV partners, swiftly load the Emmanuel TV van. They finally arrive at the Mountain of Transformation Rehabilitation Center.
Меня зовут Андрей, я являюсь директором реабилитационного центра Гора Преображения, где мы сейчас находимся.
Hello, my name is